Hey there YouTube, AJ here, and today we're going to be taking a look at, kind of reviewing, the Harbor Freight Olsen Heavy Duty Oxygen Acetylene Welding Kit. This is essentially a torch. It's not essentially, it is a torch. I don't have a torch, I needed one. So this kit was at Harbor Freight, was on sale, used a 25% off, no exclusions coupon, got it cheaper. I don't remember exactly how much I paid. I got it a little bit ago and haven't opened it yet. But we need to open it and see if it works, because I need to drop the steering arms on my hot rod from when I installed my dropped I-beam axle. And so now to get my tie rod to connect, I need to bend those arms down lower and then flatten them back out so my tie rod will connect underneath my radius rods. So let's open this thing up and see what we got. Well, first impressions, it looks like it comes in a nice case. Inside our case, we got our hoses here. We got our cutting torch head, torch body. We have a welding tip. We have your acetylene regulator, your oxygen regulator, tip cleaner. We have goggles, instruction manual, and a striker. Basic kit. And there's O-rings in here too. So we gotta see where those go. Now this torch does come with check valves built into the handle. However, it does not have come with flashback arresters for either the torch or the regulators. I personally wouldn't recommend you get a torch kit and not run it with flashback arresters. I know Harbor Freight sells regulator flashback arresters for this kit, but I went online, gave Jeff Bezos some more money, and got flashback arresters for both the torch handle and the regulators. So I just want the extra peace of mind, that safety, that I'm not gonna have an explosion. So we're gonna install this. So the torch end flashback arresters that I got came with check valves. They have check valves built into them, so you don't need to run these check valves and those. So these will come off. Now with these types of fittings, it's the ball and the brass cup which makes your seal, so you don't need to use like Teflon tape or anything with these. However, when you put all this together, you should use some kind of soapy fluid to make sure there's no leaks. And you always want to support both sides of your fitting, your tightening and loosening. Now, I have used torches in the past, but it's been a long time ago. And now, providing we don't have any leaks, we have our flashback arresters installed on our torch. So let's see how long the hose is. Let's see. 6-ish, 12-ish, looks like about 15 foot of hose. So there's our torch body attached to the hose. Now this time you would normally take your, depending on the application you're trying to do, if you're going to cut steel, you'd use your cutting head, put it on the body. This says it'll cut up to 3/4 inch steel, and it'll weld 1/16 to 1/8 inch steel. Now I'm not gonna be doing any welding with this one, quite honestly. Not intending to be brazing or welding with this tip here. And honestly, I don't know if I'll actually do much cutting, because I'm probably not really gonna use this for a lot of cutting. I might use it for some, but you know, it makes a really jagged edge and there's better ways to cut. Now when I have to cut some really thick stuff, yes, I'm gonna break out the torch. And maybe we'll cut some just to play. And when we're all done with what I'm trying to do here. So you might be asking yourself, why did I even buy this for? Well, there's other uses for torches. And I went and gave Jeff Bezos even more money and bought a rosebud tip. Now a rosebud tip has a lot more holes, a wider flame, and allows you to heat up an area. So, and that's great, that doesn't match. Ain't that special? Well, there's our first problem. This rosebud tip was supposed to fit on this torch. and it doesn't. I gotta get that sorted.
Okay, I don't know how long it's been, but between constant rain down here and traveling for work, it's been a while since I've been able to try to get back to bending my steering arms. I did get the wrong rosebud tip swapped out for the correct one, so I've got that fixed now. Got my flashback arresters installed on the torch handle. I've got them installed on the ends of my hose for the regulator end. So now we just gotta install the regulators and do a leak check of everything to make sure I don't have any leaks. Guess we'll go ahead and put the oxygen on first. My tanks are clear back here behind the car in the garage. And I don't even know if I have gas in these tanks. So we gotta find that out. But yeah, I don't have a lot of room back here. I don't even know if my hose will reach to the front end from here. And that is not the right fitting. All right, next problem on my acetylene tank. That's not the right fitting for this. It needs some kind of coupling. Oh man. So I guess we're not gonna go any further today. We gotta get the right coupling for this. Yeah, might as well at least see if we have any gas in the oxygen. Hey, we have oxygen. So that's cool. And we turn this in. This tells you your pressure on the other side. So this gauge is the pressure on your hose side. This gauge is the pressure in your tank. I don't hear any leaks. Eventually I will get some soap and water out and test all the fittings for leaks. But for now, we're just gonna go ahead and let it off. And turn off the tank. Because we gotta get a fitting to go from here to our regulator. We got two male fittings, so they're not going to go together. So I ordered the adapter from Amazon, got it all ready. Hasn't even been 12 hours since I ordered it, so that's awesome. So let's hope I got the right adapter. So it fits the regulator side, that's good. All right, I think we're in business. I had to put my regulator at a weird angle because of the length of the hoses here. Hey, we actually have some acetylene. All right. So we have gas to the regulators. We have gas in the bottles. So now we need to pressurize the hose and check for leaks and everything.
Okay, I leak checked my lines. Nothing fun to show there. I had no bubbles or anything, so we're ready to try this. I have all my safety gear on. I have a fire extinguisher nearby. I should stress, this is not a how to use a torch video. You are on your own for learning how to do that safely. Everybody's got different levels of comfort. Me personally, I'm not comfortable using a torch, so I'm not comfortable teaching someone. So I'm gonna do my best here and see if I can do this. I wanna thank Ryan over at Between the Sharks for giving me the idea of using what he called a story stick. Basically, it's this old piece of fork tube, and I've wrapped tape around it to where the top side of the tape is where the top of my steering arm currently is, and the bottom side of it is where I need it to be. So this keeps me from having to have a lighted torch in my hands, fumbling with the tape measure with gloves on and off, and trying to measure the distance I need to drop my arm. I've already figured that out ahead of time. Yeah, I need to basically drop about 1.25 inches. So that's the distance of my tape there. And that'll give me a good quick way to eyeball how I'm doing along the way. I do also have a wet towel wrapped around my kingpin, trying to protect all that some, best I can. I don't have a piece of pipe to use to bend my arm, so I'm gonna use my pipe wrench. Hopefully it'll be sufficient. So I think the only thing left to do is fire up the torch and see if we can bend some metal. I think it's starting to get close now. Yeah.
This is where it'd be nice to have someone to hold the torch while I worked. Starting to bend a little easier now. Yeah, I think I need to take it just a little further. Okay, you don't want to cool this off fast. Hopefully you can see. So you can see that the end of my tie rod, don't want to touch any of this, it's really hot. The end where my tie rod mounts, the top of it's now below my bottom tape line. So I'm going to let that cool a little bit, and then we have to bend the end of this back up to where it's level to the bottom of that tape line. Is it going to hit anywhere? Nope, I think we're good there. Now what we need to do is heat it up right here and bend this part up. Got a better flame this time. Didn't have enough acetylene going the last time, I think. Bet you it'll heat up faster this time now that I've got my mix right. Oh yeah, it's heating up a lot faster this time. That actually looks pretty good. I might need to bend it a little more down, I think. Lost my heat. I need to drop it just a little more before I level it back out again. We should be able to level it out and we'll be good. Come on. This is where having a pipe would be easier. Level. think we are good there. The arm's dropped. I think it looks pretty good. I think it's gonna work for us. We have good clearance over here, all the way lock to lock. I may eventually need to drop this upper arm, but I'm not sure yet. So we're just gonna let that go for now until we get our steering mounted. So for now, this side's good. We are going to let all this cool off, put the wheel tire back on so we can set it back on the ground and get set up to do the other side. All right, we're set up for the other side. Let's see what we can do here. Definitely helps to get your oxygen and acetylene mix right. Heats it up a lot faster. Well, we need to go a little further. Okay, that should be good. Now on this side, there's two eyes. The end eye, that's because these linkages were for a cross steer. And that end eye is gonna get cut off. So you want to make sure that your glove's on fire. So you want to make sure that you're bending to the correct spot, the right eye, which is the rear, the one closest to the axle in this case. Catching fire, so I had to abandon it. All right, so that's got to come down a little bit further. We're about an eighth inch too high right now, so we got to go back up to heat it up here again. Hopefully this will get it, but maybe not. I might have to go back and forth like that a couple times to get it to the right spot I want. We're a bit low. I need to light it back up. Okay. I said it before, but I think I got it now. Yeah, it looks pretty good there. All right. So it looks like everything's going to clear nice, not hitting anything. Remember, we're going to be using this eye back here, not this one up here. That's going to get cut off. I think we're ready to let this side cool and then get it back on the ground. Well, I got my steering arms lowered and there was no earth-shattering kaboom, which is a good thing in this case, because an earth-shattering kaboom would have meant that something went drastically wrong with my torch setup. I have to say, working with the torch, all that went fine. I did get my tie rod back on and connected. As you can see, I got a little bit of toe end problem here. I got to get my tie rod adjusted with the dropped axle where I had it adjusted before, changed it a little bit. So that's no big deal. We'll get that fixed squared away. But you can see on my driver's side where we're lowered. We have about a finger's width of room under the radius arm and between that and the tie rod. Over here on the passenger side, the same thing. We got that finger's width of room. And if we look down here, we've got a level stuck to the tie rod and it's sitting pretty much dead nuts level. So yeah, I'd say everything went pretty well. A lot of stress in me building up to doing this one. Something I've never done before. So I gotta say, using the Harbor Freight torch, I had to learn a lot to use it. I'm by no means an expert. I'm not telling you how to use a torch, but overall, it seems to be pretty well made, pretty well constructed. It worked really well for me. I will say a few things about it. One thing being that it does not come with the flashback arresters for the torch end or for the regulator end. So that's extra expense you got to plan on right there. It doesn't come with a rosebud tip like this, which I wanted a rosebud tip because I will probably be using it more for heating and bending metal. That will probably be my primary use, so I wanted to invest in a good tip for heating metal. You probably could have done this using the cutting tip or the, I don't know about the welding tip because it seemed pretty small. This just makes it a whole lot easier having the right tool for the right job, man. So that said, construction, everything seemed fine on this torch. The regulators seemed to work very well. I adjusted them per the manual and per the settings needed for pressures on the rosebud tip. I will say at first I was worried about the length of the hose. It's being only 15 feet or so. That doesn't seem to be a problem for a small shop like mine. I've got the tank set up right at the back of the car. I was able to use the hose all the way at the front end of the car and work with no problem. I think for a home hobbyist, it's plenty long enough. The only negative I really have to say about it is this distance here between where the hoses are joined together and where they go into the regulators. Where I'm using, I don't know what size oxygen bottle I've got here, but I've got a B tank for my acetylene. And that distance there made it kind of rough. I had to put my, you see how I had to turn my regulator flat to where I could get the hoses to connect to both while I was using it. That's not insurmountable, but you know, it's kind of a pain for what I'm doing. Oops, I forgot to put my chain back on after I installed the regulator. Yeah, that's really my only negative is how short this little separation are. I guess you call it the whips or whatever. And yeah, and you have to know that you got to buy these extra as well. Other than that, the quality of the tool seems to be fairly nice. I don't make my living with a torch, so I don't have to use it in it day in, day out, worry about it getting banged around on a job site. It's all my responsibility to take care of it, so shouldn't be a problem for using it here in my garage. I'm going to be using it in the future to heat and bend my frame horn straight. This one's got a little tweak to it, so I want to get it evened out with the other one. There'll be other things I'll be using it to heat and bend, so I think it's a pretty good investment for my little garage. All that said, again, thanks to Ryan for helping me come up with the idea how to measure that quick and easy. If you haven't checked out Between the Sharks, check him out. Real cool guy. He's building a very similar Model T. His is also a 26-27 Model T Touring, but he's building it with fenders, a little more modern components. He's not trying to stay all traditional. He's got some disc brakes and things like that. So, but it's still a cool build. You gotta check him out if you haven't. Anyway, I do appreciate that little tip using a story stick to be able to quickly measure how much you've dropped it and if you got it far enough. That helped immensely. Didn't have to juggle a tape measure and a torch and gloves and all that deal. So, awesome. So I think that's where we're gonna leave it for now. I think what's up next for the car, a couple things. I'm gonna start adding some stiffness to the body. And off and on, I'm gonna be doing a little body work here and there, like the things that need to be, where metal has split. Basically any place that there's a weakness in the body itself. Mainly I want to focus on getting the across the back of the front cab and back of the rear cab, getting that. There's used to be wood there, so I want to strengthen that up. The other things that could be next on the chopping block to tackle is getting my mounting points for my front radius rods and my rear radius rods, getting those tacked into place and getting those located. That'll be a big step so I can start moving forward with the car. So I think those three things are what I'll be tackling next. Don't know what order yet, but we'll see when we get there. But till then, YouTube, later.